when you hear them say, "I wouldn't quit, not for nothing, Jeff," you can't tell me somewhere in the back of your mind there's not a little part of you saying, "I am quitting."
Take it for whatever you want. I mean, if you want to say quitting, you want to say stopping, yeah, I'm quitting. My health to me is more important to me than $1 million, I guess, right now. Does the mean justify the ends? No, it doesn't.
Let me ask you something, Austin. Have you wondered what the hell you're doing out here?
You know what? I'm clearly out of my element. As a situation, I would have thought that, hey, give it a shot. I can at least say, hey, I went and tried it. I like to be successful. Apparently, I'm not going to be. But, you know, I won't live my life saying, what if?
I've been at about 100 tribal councils. Never, ever seen anybody lay down their torch. So this is a first for me. Seems unanimous. I just want to make sure. Savage, you're going to indulge Austin. Send him home.
Yes.
Dara.
Yeah.
Rhino.
Yep.
T.
Yeah.
No need to vote. Don't waste any more time. Grab your torch. Austin, per your wishes, go home.
Okay. Wait. Due to someone who's very ill at home right now, that's getting worse, I need to pull myself out of the game and be there. I love this game so much, but my priority is my family. And it just doesn't make any sense for me to be here anymore. So I need to take myself out of the game.
So are you talking about your mom?
Yeah. Yeah. She's just not any better, and things have gotten a little worse quickly.
You're talking as though you're getting information, updates on your mom in the last 9 days.
She's my mother, and I'm the only child. I got a vibe. I got a feeling that she needs me there. My dad needs me there. Everybody needs me there. I made a bad judgment call. I shouldn't have came. I thought that I could do it and she would want me to, and I was wrong. I should be there in case something happens. I'll never forgive myself. You gotta weigh out your options. I love this game, but it's my family.
Fair enough.
Bring in a boat.
We're thinking about you.
Hi, guys. Have fun.
Richard Hatch, sort of being inappropriate.
Sort of, yeah.
Anybody have any comments?
I was sexually violated. To have some guy come up, he passed a half a dozen people on platforms and never touched them.
Sue, I'm...
And it went too far, and he crossed the line, and he crossed the line with me.
Well...
Okay, I know you don't know. And you didn't see it because his back was to you, and he's too big of a slob to see around. I was violated, humiliated, dehumanized, and totally spent, Jeff. It wasn't sort of, Jeff, because his back was to you, Jeff. That's all I'm saying, and I'm spent, and I'm done with this game. There's no way I can continue with my... emotions to push to the ground that much.
So when you say you're done with the game, as in you want out of the game?
I'm done. I'm walking away.
Let's, if we can, bring in this boat ASAP.
I'm so sorry, Sue. I'm so sorry. I didn't see him. I'm so sorry. Guys, good luck.
Janu, if you had your way, what would happen tonight?
I would ask the tribe to vote me out and keep Stephanie in.
What's the difference between you laying your torch down and you looking to this group and saying, vote me out?
I guess after reflecting and understanding this, there would be no difference. So I would be willing to lay down my torch so that Stephanie can have a chance to stay in the game.
Not just for me. If she wants to lay down her torch and she wants to quit this game, she can do it, but not on my account.
Do you want me to rephrase it? What I am saying is I will lay down my torch, and I don't want Stephanie to feel that I am doing it for her. That's something that I have to do.
I just want to be clear. You are on your own quitting this game.
Yes, Jeff. I will lay down my torch this evening.
Well, I don't know if it's appropriate. We have rain coming down. Maybe this is your final epiphany or cleansing moment. I see that you brought all your belongings. Go ahead and gather them. Bring your torch over. Shanu, per your wishes, this game is over for you, but you will not go home. You'll return and be a part of our jury.
Thank you, Jeff.
Good night.
So, well, I got word that you wanted to see me. You've had enough. What's going on? It's 19 days you've been out here. Let me come over here.
I kind of, sat on the boat for a while today, and I couldn't feel my family, you know, and I'm never leaving my baby girl or my husband again ever for this amount of time ever again.
So what is it that you've had a tough time out here? You've had it as tough as anybody with all the time on exile, but you've weathered all that. So you want to leave, you're leaving. There's no, I'm not here to talk you into staying, that's for sure.
Right.
I just want to understand it.
I was doing it for everybody else, doing it for my husband, doing it for my sister who wants to live vicariously through me. I don't want to hurt these people, so I want to stay to help them. This is like the first decision I've made that's like for me. You know, because I don't want to let anybody down. I don't want anybody to hate me. I don't want anybody to think that I'm quitting.
You've certainly given it your best.
Yeah. Oh, God.
And all's going to be okay. Ready to get out of here?
I am.
Let's get your stuff.
You can't fault her. You can't be upset with her. We hope she has a good trip, and I'm sure I'll see her again.
Right now, Nayanka, you have a 1 in 9 shot at $1 million. Yes or no, are you going to stay in this game and fight for a shot to win it, or are you going to quit?
I'm going to quit.
Nayanka's going to quit. Purple Kelly, you now have a 1 in 8 shot at winning this game. Your odds just improved with Nayanka quitting. You gonna stay and fight, or you gonna quit?
I'm gonna quit.
Purple Kelly's gonna quit. All right, so I'll snuff your torches, but we're gonna keep them here at Tribal Council. They'll be a reminder to you guys when you come back in here as part of the jury of the decision you made to quit. All right, Nayanka, grab your torch. You want to go?
Yes.
Go. Purple Kelly, grab a torch. Head out.
And now, Colton, you're crying. What are you crying about?
I don't want to be here anymore. At all. And I'm sorry.
Don't quit, Colton.
I can't do this.
Meaning what? Meaning you're quitting again?
Don't quit, Colton.
I can't do this.
So, Colton, you came back for a second time because you said, I've changed. I've grown, and I want to show everybody. You're now doing the exact opposite.
I don't care about this tribe.
Well, that's clear, because you're punishing them by costing them a tribe member in a game about numbers in which ultimately you may merge.
Well, then maybe that's the best move for me.
A very selfish move.
Well.
Admittedly, a selfish
admittedly,
move?
Admittedly, but maybe it's the best one for me.
What is it that has happened on your tribe that's forcing you to quit for what now I can confirm for myself is a second time? The first time you feigned an appendicitis. Turns out you didn't have it. You want to own that one now?
I don't know what it was. I mean, I was treated for a bacterial infection, you know? People can say to the cows, come home, I quit. My back's against the wall, and when my back is against the wall in this game, I turn into the person I was in One World, and I don't want to be that person. I'm tired of being hated by everybody. I'm tired of being...
You turned into that person before your back was against the wall.
So, Colt, are you quitting this game?
Yes.
Okay, you are out of the game. Well, Colton, you came back for a second time because you said you wanted to show how much you've grown, but your behavior now shows you haven't. And the irony is, the opportunity for the growth you seek is right in front of you. It's called Survivor. You can keep your buff. I won't give you the honor of throwing that in the urn. We'll keep that reserved for people who compete. Grab your stuff, head out, boat will pick you up.
Love you, babe.
Situation. I'd rather... you know, cost me $1 million than for my daughter to see your mom act like that.
So this is just between you and Trish. It's just a personality conflict.
But it's so extreme. And I'm cold, and I'm wet, and I'm hungry, and I know that, and I'm tired. I get all those things, and I know I'm gonna regret it. I need $1 million more than anybody here. And I can honestly say I can't take it anymore.
You're quitting?
I don't know what else to do.
I gotta say, this is a first. No one has ever quit because they were afraid they were gonna do something they regretted. And so they took a moment and said, my best move is to just move on.
It makes me really, really sad. This has been a big struggle for me.
So I'm really here just to officially inform you that after losing Cliff and what appeared to be a big blindside, Lindsay's pulling herself from the game.
I do feel bad because I kind of came down on her, but she got nasty. She was mean. And
yeah.
Then she just walked away, and I'm not the least bit surprised that she's quit because she can't live without Cliff.
Yeah, it's like Mean Girls.
So the fact that you think you're pretty much on the verge of being voted out, and your man's not here.
And
I'm done.
I can't stay here because Misty says we need you. I know why you need me is because you want me to be here to help you get further in the game, but I'm compromising what I feel I need right now.
All right, Julie, so officially, you're quitting the game.
Yes.
Okay. 18 days, your adventure is over. I'll go let the tribe know.
Okay, thank you.
Something's happening.
Guys, come on down out of the shelter. There's a log up here. Let's just sit on this. All right, so bad news and good news. Bad news is, if you were in an alliance with Julie, you just lost a member. Julie is quitting the game. All right, been a tough 10 days. B, your knee is wrapped and you're limping. What's going on with you?
I actually have to make a really sad announcement. I sprained my MCL yesterday, and I'm an athlete, so I've made the decision to leave the game.
It's okay, B.
Okay. How are you? I'm so sorry.
It's okay. It's all right. You guys do it. It's good for you.
All right. B has made her decision. B is quitting the game. Grab your stuff. Head down to the water's edge. We'll grab a boat for you.
Take care, B.
Pick you up.
Love you, B.
Great work, B. Really.